Hello everyone, my name is Pedro and I'm very glad to present you dadaGP, a dataset of tokenized GuitarPro songs for sequence models. Jumping right away to the main contributions of this paper, we highlight the dadaGP dataset itself, consisting of more than 25,000 songs in both GuitarPro format, which is used for tablature edition, and a dedicated token format. In order to switch from GuitarPro to token format, we also provide a Python tool that is able to convert between the two, either encoding from GuitarPro to tokens, or from tokens to GuitarPro format. Finally, as one of the applications for this dataset is automatic music generation, we present a use case where we train the transformer model to generate multi-instrument rock pieces. Diving a little deeper, let's start with one of the reasons for the creation of this dataset. While there are many symbolic music datasets in the community, most of them resort on the MIDI format, which digitally encodes musical expression features such as pitch and loudness. On the other hand, tablatures, which are the type of notation used in guitar profiles, also indicate where to play a specific note on the instrument. By leveraging the information in GuitarPro format, we intend to provide a dataset which captures much more features that are specific to guitars and other string instruments, features that cannot be encoded via MIDI. Focusing on the dataset itself, dadaGP contains 26,181 GuitarPro songs with a total duration of over than 1,200 hours. A distinctive aspect of dadaGP is its genre distribution. With over 700 different musical genres, its corpus is diverse, but there's a larger proportion from genres and subgenres from rock and metal. In terms of instruments, dadaGP supports songs with up to 3 distorted guitars, 2 clean guitars, 1 bass guitar, 1 drum kit, 1 extra instrument with sharp attacks named lead, and a final one to use more ambiently called path. Moreover, as we said before, its encoder-decoder tool converts guitar profiles into text files with special tokens. In order to build this, we leveraged the PyGuitarPro library and based our token syntax in formats from previous words such as MuseNet, Remi, and CP. Syntactically, every song in token format begins with an artist, downtune, tempo and start token, and ends with an end token. Regarding pitched instruments, its syntax ensures that we describe not only the note but also where it is played on the fretboard. Concerning drums, the syntax explores GuitarPro drum MIDI maps, where a number is assigned to a specific instrument in the drum kit. In terms of note durations, in dadaGP we use a tick resolution of 960 ticks per quarter note. Here the wait token is used to specify the number of ticks between each note or rest event. In order to capture guitar-specific playing techniques, we created the note effect and beat effect tokens, which allows the encoder to notate techniques like tapping, ending, palm muting, hammer-ons and pull-offs, amongst many others. Finally, in order to demonstrate the use of dadaGP on music generation, we devised a use case where we first filter around 7,000 songs labeled as rock. We then trained a model based on the Transformer XL architecture, creating a simple evaluation metric that would account for what we define as grammar errors, namely the incorrect positioning and repetition of tokens. As expected, the number of errors diminished considerably as training progressed from epoch 10 to 50. To conclude, here's a little taste from one of the samples we've produced. If you're curious to know a bit more about dadaGP, please check out the paper and feel free to ask or email any questions. Thank you for watching.